That's right, y'all are now tuned in to Bars on Hoops Radio. The Unorganized Behavior team is in the building. Yo, Dez, go ahead, take it away, man.
Now, you know I have to do my intro like I do on all shows. Urban legends are born every day, and I am one. I am the nose hunter. TERESA Taylor, thank you so much for coming in. Ooh. It is a pleasure having you.
Absolutely.
Amazing artist.
Thank you.
Now, for our listeners, I'd like to know, please tell our listeners where you're from and your background.
So I am from Queens, New York.
Shout out to Queens.
Yeah, shout out to Queens. Queens in the building. But my background is Jamaican. So I was born in Jamaica and raised in Queens.
For those that are illiterate to geography, what part of Jamaica?
Jamaica.
Yes.
Jamaica, West
they
Indies.
Might think Jamaica, Queens.
Not Jamaica,
exactly.
Queens.
They might be thinking the bus terminal.
They might be thinking Jamaica Ave.
No.
Okay.
Jamaica, West Indies.
So now I'm wonderful, saying that you are from Jamaica, right? And of course you have multiple influences from, you know, American styles of music,
yeah,
as well as Caribbean style of,
yes,
music. Now,
mm-hmm,
growing up, tell me, how was it like growing up in a Caribbean household? Was it very strict and disciplined compared to,
yeah,
my lazy American ways?
Extremely. Yeah, 100%. It was great, though. I think everybody who grows up in a Caribbean culture, even though it's strict and we grow up to complain about a lot of things, I feel like we really wouldn't change anything about it. You know what I mean? It's something I feel like we'll pass down anyway. Yeah, so a lot of memories, a lot of discipline for sure, strict, especially on girl children. They're definitely more strict, but I really wouldn't change anything about it. It's something to look back at and laugh at.
Now, let me ask you another question.
Mm-hmm.
Around that, did you ever have to get your own stick to the discipline as a child?
I didn't have to get my own stick, but I had to get my own belt, my own shoes, my own pot, you know. Yeah, definitely had to grab whatever it took for them to hit me.
So, as an artist, right, a recording artist,
yeah,
musically, who was the first person to motivate you and inspire you to say, you know what, I want to tap into layers of my talent and really pursue it, like growing up and being a student of music?
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to say just one person, but definitely Whitney Houston.
I think
everybody says that, but also in the Caribbean, that's number one for Caribbean people too. Whitney Houston, Celine Dion. You know, reggae wise, I would say Tessan Chin. I'm a real big Tessan Chin fan.
Okay.
So yeah, those people for sure.
Now, those are mostly singers, of course, right?
Yeah.
Whitney Houston.
Mm-hmm.
Anyone, because you know, reggae is very big,
yeah,
in Jamaica.
Mm-hmm.
Any reggae artist that inspired you?
Oh, well, Tessan is a reggae artist. Tessan,
yes,
Chin, she's a reggae artist. But other than that, I love Chronic's. I wouldn't say growing up because he's relatively new within the last few years.
Okay.
But I love Chronic's. Barris Hammond for sure.
Oh, legend.
Barris is
legendary.
Like the Beyonce of reggae music, I guess.
Definitely
you would
is.
Say.
Every party.
Barris Hammond for sure. Yeah. Garnet Silk. Yeah. Those are big, big names that influence me.
It's just like the artist you mentioned is like you're a student, like how Tiny's a student of hip hop. He's like the,
yeah,
walk-in encyclopedia of like classic hip hop.
Yeah.
You know, I got Tiny here. We always getting plenty of arguments about, you know, legends of rap and feel like they have,
right,
to pay homage. Legends of music. Do you feel like that's a requirement of being like a master of your art form, just knowing the people that came before you and just studying different styles?
Yeah, I think so, because I think that we don't realize how much we're influenced. I mean, I think, granted, some people kind of get the opportunity first, so they get,
yes,
to show an idea first that someone else may have had already, but you know, didn't have the platform. But I think that we're influenced by so much that we can't always just say it was me that,
okay,
came up with this, or you know, I did this on my own, or this is my complete style. You know, we have to kind of acknowledge the people who made us at least love doing what we do or want to do what we do. So yeah, I think it's a requirement.
Excellent. Nice. Now, as an artist and the years that you have been recording, the years that you've been practicing and mastering your art,
mm-hmm,
what prerequisites do you feel are required, in your opinion, to be a successful recording artist and just let our listeners know what, you know, Teresa Taylor feels.
I mean, a requirement to be successful, I think that you have to actually care about the craft. You know what I mean? Because I feel like you'll fizzle out if it's just about anything else other than the love for what you want to do. You know what I mean? And you'll be easily influenced by people who are like, no, do it like this, do it like that, because you don't actually care.
Definitely. You have to have a passion.
Yeah, 100%.
For your work.
100%.
So it starts like, so, I mean, of course, like anything else, it's heart first.
Yeah.
It's heart first, then it's like probably hard work, right?
Yeah. I would say so.
Now, you know, being a recording artist, how many hours would you say that you spend in the studio?
Mm-hmm.
Just like, for instance, one song, I mean, one track, or just laying down one set of vocals?
It's kind of hard to say, because every song requires a different level of work, but definitely quite a few hours. I feel like there's times I've been in the studio for like 3 hours on one song, just because it's rare that you record one song in one shot. You know what I mean? Usually it's kind of in pieces. You do one part and it's like, all right, that part is good. And then you wanna layer it. You wanna do take after take. So yeah, to get it right, I feel like it's at least 3 hours.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you know, of course, we heard your music.
Yeah.
And
very
to us,
beautiful.
It's like it's very beautiful music, and it takes a certain amount of perfection. Like, I'm a Virgo, so I know about perfection.
Okay.
Yeah. Exactly.
I'm a Libra.
All right. So
I'm right after you.
I'm the 21st.
I'm an Aries. I'm just hard-headed.
Yeah.
My brother's an Aries.
No,
I agree with you.
I'm a Capricorn.
Okay.
Tiny.
That's right. We're going to let y'all know what it is. A Capricorn, definitely.
Oh, man.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, we know Tiny. See what I got to deal with? I got to deal with two hard-headed people.
Look, I have to say.
Just stay out of it,
just
all right?
Staying out of this.
Now, what official age did you start singing? Like, was it like, you know, some artists always say like, okay, well, I started in the choir.
Mm-hmm.
I started at talent shows.
Yeah.
What was your start of your journey?
I feel like I've always been singing since I was like a kid, like 5 years old, just singing around the house. But elementary school is really when I kind of like went hard with performing, with being on stage, with dancing, with anything entertainment, talent shows. I did a lot of those things in elementary school. I was like, you know, 8 years old.
Oh,
that's
wow.
When, yeah, I was really like finding my space around that time.
So you were blowing those kids out the water that didn't know how to have tempo or anything.
I mean, I'd like to think so.
Sheesh. Okay. So on the come up, of course,
mm-hmm.
What collabs have you done? Have you ever done any collabs with any other up and coming artists or current artists that we hear today?
I have not done any collabs with current artists, definitely some local artists that are also really, really dope along the way. I would love to do some collaborations with current artists, especially write for them, because I'm a writer as well. So, yeah, that's definitely a dream of mine, to collab with them in that way for sure.
I'd like to know, do you find that you would like to collab with more females or male artists?
It doesn't really matter to me, because as long as the music is good, as long as the music portrays kind of like my vision, I'm down for it. I've always had it in mind to collab with Miguel. I just love him. I just feel like I'm the female version of Miguel.
I was going to say, now that you mention it, you kind of look like him a little bit. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my God.
You could be related. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, he's so talented, and he has just an amazing vibe that I think our musical energies would match.
Mm-hmm.
So that's someone for sure. Always wanted to write for Queen Naija, Tiana Taylor. So, yeah, it doesn't matter to me, male or female.
The reason why I asked this question is because as I look through your work,
yeah.
I noticed that you you speak on encouraging women.
Yeah.
And so there's a stigma up amongst women,
yeah.
That we all hate each other.
Yeah.
And, you know, talk shit behind each other's back and smile in the face. So I'm curious.
You stay
shut
out
up
this.
Over there. All right. So I want to know, I noticed you expose yourself a lot in that manner, and I want to know what drives you to expose yourself that way and encourages you to want to encourage other women to do the same.
You know, I feel like as a Libra person too, we're so like harmony driven and just kind of like wanting everybody to get along. And also I think women
Well, that's a wonderful trait.
Yeah.
Take notes, take lessons.
Take notes over there. and women get put down a lot, honestly. I mean, even look at the situation with Megan the Stallion. You know what I mean? Like, when I look through the comments, sometimes it's a lot of other women.
Who is this for the ones who don't know?
Megan Thee Stallion. Yes. She's a rapper. There's a case going on between her and Tory Lanez that supposedly he shot her and in the foot, and a lot of people didn't believe that
Ridiculous.
He assaulted her. Yeah, it's a lot going around it. You know, the one thing I do feel kind of taken aback about is how many women are in the comments tearing her apart
and defending Tory Lanez
and defending Tory. And I get people who feel like, well, let everybody get a chance to explain themselves, but that's not what people are saying. People are really going in on her. And I think that's what kind of drives me to say, I see so much of that. Let's put out this energy. Let's put out the energy where women can come together and not know each other and say, I have your back, and say, I believe you, and say, I'm with you, and I encourage you to do, you know, whatever your passion is, whatever you believe in. So I just feel like, if I'm an advocate for that, it's because I just don't see enough of it in my, you know, in my current circle or on the media. Mm-hmm. So.
And that's amazing too. Like, also as a man, we can also advocate for women as well.
Yeah.
I think, you know, hearing your music, that can inspire men to, you know, do the right thing and shun any type of behavior. Like this whole Tory Lanez situation is basically giving an okay to domestic violence, because at the end of the day, no matter what the weapon was to injure, someone was injured, and the intent. So, you know, like I said,
man, his punk ass shot.
Yeah, we know we have our opinion about Tory Lanez. You know,
man, his punk ass shot her. He shot at her. Or regardless of the fact, man, he pulled the trigger. He might have shot down at the ground or something. It wind up hitting her in the foot or whatever the case may be. His punk ass shot her.
Well, maybe he needs to drink some milk and grow a little bit. I think that would be the case.
Time to get past the childhood trauma.
My question is, if it was just an argument and they were arguing amongst themselves in there, why did you have to pull a gun out?
Because
at what point did it say, yo, let me pull the gun out?
Because he's 5'1" and he has a Napoleon complex. That's why he did
it. Insecurities.
Okay, so off that topic.
Yeah. Okay. I digress.
So.
Well, that's wonderful that you encourage other women. That's wonderful.
Now, with the, of course, this year with the quarantine and the whole music industry changing, what's your opinion about the R&B versus battles? And which one was your favorite?
Oh, my God.
It was definitely a lot of talent. A lot of talent, a lot of guys that should not have been partaking in that.
Oh, crap. Listen, I'm going to let you finish off that sentence, but I really enjoyed it. I feel like I watched every single one, all of the verses. Definitely my favorite is going to be Beanie Man and Bounty Killer, because...
Oh, that was fire.
You know. Hello.
Listen, that's my favorite too. I think they did the best thus far.
Yes.
But you still have some good ones.
No, absolutely. Right. Absolutely.
That was the best to me thus far.
That was the best, especially it kind of set the trend for everybody else to be in the same space and have proper sound equipment and things like that. But as far as R&B, I'm trying to run back everybody who performed. I did love Brandy and Monica.
Did you like the shoes?
I like the shoes. Both legendary. I mean, I love Brandy. Like, I can't find a bad thing to say about Brandy's music. So that was definitely one of my favorites. I love Jill. You know, that was a good one, too. Yeah, that was dope. That was a real neo-soul vibe. But R&B-wise, That one I actually did not really get to watch that one live because I was away.
I didn't see it either. Yeah. Don't feel bad.
But again, legends. So, I mean, I don't expect anything less than an amazing show from them. So, yeah, I enjoyed all of them.
Now, who was that with that was dancing a bit? Was that Teddy Riley in one of them? Yeah. What'd you think about Teddy Riley and who and Tiny?
Teddy and Babyface?
Yeah, Teddy and Babyface.
He was dancing?
Yeah, he was dancing. I mean, his man was his boy is dancing in the background.
Oh, my God. How could I forget that meme? That was amazing. Babyface, I'm sorry. Babyface is just a different breed of
he's the
a person.
GOAT. I think he's the GOAT. What do you think?
Absolutely. The penmanship, he's 100%. Amazing.
He's so classy.
He's amazing. Yeah, and
he's
classy.
Lovely.
He's so smooth. He's like, what was that? Next? Okay.
He's lovely.
And you could see him when he was sitting in the versus battle. It wasn't even competitive. Like he was just sitting there like
smooth.
All the antics and he just sat back in his studio and was like, all right, you guys done. Like my catalog is not even 10% finished.
True. He's like, let me get my guitar while you guys load up.
I have to ask you this though. And this has been trending across social media. Jaguar Wright of the Roots.
Jaguar who of the what?
Of the Roots. Jaguar Wright.
I haven't seen that. The trend.
Oh, the trend about Jaguar Wright. And she was talking about her experiences in the industry as a female artist.
Mm.
She was a Roots and she left the Roots.
Okay.
Okay. So Jaguar Wright right now is that's the woman that's like exposing the industry, things that certain artists have to go through and so
forth. I
should
check that out.
Yeah, you definitely check it out.
Wow.
It's very, very interesting and like what we were talking about of being a female artist. I just wanted to, see if you saw it. It's been trending.
I didn't get to see it, but what was her main argument about it?
Her main argument was basically exposing different people in the music industry.
Like, what were they doing?
Well, misconduct.
Okay.
That's pretty much it. That's why I say,
say no more.
It's very spicy.
Boy.
Say no more.
She went at everybody. She said Jill Scott stole her style.
Yep.
She said Diddy. Christopher Williams got caught giving fellatio to Diddy.
Ouch.
Sheesh!
Yes.
I was trying not to go to Tiny, but Johnny is unorganized behavior.
Let's talk. Let's talk.
Than
she
I
said.
Thought.
She said Mary
Hotter
J.
Than
Blige.
My tea.
She said Mary J. Blige need to come out the closet.
Oh come
she
on.
She said Tevin Campbell was the prostitute in the industry.
Come on, Tevin. Come on.
See, Tiny. I know it's unorganized.
Well,
I was trying. I was trying to be civilized, but you had to open the worms up.
No, no. Okay. Let's call it what it is.
All right, we're gonna call it what it is. I got you.
She said, "Common raped her."
Ooh, my God.
For some reason.
And the ghostwriting things, I have to question that.
Yeah, the ghostwriting thing. She said, she got on Common. I mean, not Common. She got on camera. She got on. Every day she's getting on a different person from the industry.
Damn, she know a lot. She know a lot of people.
Talib Kweli, where Talib Kweli had to respond. Who she say was gay? Yo, she was just going
she
in.
In.
Yo, she was going in. For
well,
real.
Do you believe the things that she's saying?
No.
Okay.
And that's why
that's
we
that
need
on that.
And that's why we need you as a saver in the entertainment industry. And this is what we were talking about earlier.
Yeah.
I do. That's why I brought up the versus battles and everything like that, because it's a battle across the board. It's like people don't realize like art and war go together. Like when, we talked about astrology earlier, but music's released on Tuesday, Mars and so forth.
Yeah.
And it's, it's very competitive, and you having longevity here being, as an artist, do you feel like people you influence other artists with your style and maybe people that you're that students of you but not really like right there like low-key that study your craft?
I feel like definitely I influence people who follow me, not in the sense that they may want to copy everything that I'm doing, but they might feel more confident to just do their art and more confident to do things their way, because I know for me, I try not to switch up my morals or my style. So, hopefully other people that's following me get that kind of same energy to say, just be yourself and do your thing. So, I think in that way, for sure, there's people who are, picking up on that about me.
And, in hearing your music, it's more, because I want our listeners to hear your music, But before we even get to your music,
yeah,
when I hear your music, I hear like it's so blends of styles. Like mm-hmm. I love R&B music as well. Yes. I like classic 90s.
Lovely,
music.
Lovely.
Like I'm looking at like Groove Theory, by the way. That was one of the smooth theory, yeah. like tempo your music has, and I'm like, this reminds me of Groove Theory, but it's mm-hmm. like different though. Mm-hmm. It's like I can see the Caribbean influence.
Yeah.
I can see the soul influence.
Yeah.
I can see the, even when you say Whitney Houston, I can actually still see some of the 80s.
Mm-hmm. Even like, farther back than that, I felt like 50s.
Yeah. Really?
And some of the, yeah, I got like a Nina Simone vibe.
Okay, got you.
On one of your songs. Nina Simone, I think it's smooth. Called Imaginal.
Imaginal. Oh, yeah, the interlude.
That was yeah. really beautiful. Mm-hmm. I was really shocked. No offense, because
now everybody you can know, come up here,
yeah. right? No, but you know, people think that you know they're making music and yeah. you know whatever. But mm-hmm. but yours was very beautiful. I even told Desmond. I was like, oh my god! I was like, this girl's really.
I told you, but you're hard headed.
I appreciate you listening.
I gotta see to believe. But I mean, you proved. Proved it to me, so thank you. I thought it thank was very you. Beautiful.
And thank like
you.
I said, not everybody can come up here.
That's okay. right. That's
We've
right.
had rappers up here. Not too many, mm-hmm. but some bomb. We're not going to say the names. Oh, you know, we're not going to say the names.
Not many females, though.
Yeah.
Many females, though. Have there been many females?
Not rappers, but we did have, starting now, of course, we're going to have female rappers coming up now, okay. especially from Queens. You know, Queens represent, of course.
Yeah. yeah.
And, you know, that's the great thing about it. Like, mm-hmm. you know, we always have talent that comes up here mm-hmm. that sets the bar. Your music, mm-hmm. when our listeners hear it, mm-hmm. is going to set a new bar. Okay,
well, from, I hope so.
Yes, it's thank very you. Beautiful.
The thank one, you, thank you. The one, I'm not musically inclined, so excuse my verbiage.
Okay.
The musically one tone, mm-hmm. the... people that sound like they're singing in the shower.
Oh, okay. I see where you're going with this.
You know, I don't know what to call it. I would just say one tone, monotone, one level, monotone. Okay. Do you feel, just like how hip-hop bars is coming back, do you feel like that's coming back in music where people are now being more serious than, okay, I'm just going to sing a song that can be on a fast food commercial.
Right.
I'm just singing to sing and feel like, okay, well, I'm just singing like I'm at a barbecue or something like that. Mm. What do you think?
I think artists are giving people what they say they want. And I say that because if I make a certain style of music and people are like, eh, if I want to be successful, I'm probably going to feel that pressure to switch it up and probably do what everybody else is doing. Even if deep within my catalog, I know I have much more to offer than this monotone style. But if when I do this monotone style, people are like, yes, I love this. I'm going to pay for your concerts. And you want to be successful. You want to make a name for yourself. That's pretty much the wave you're going to ride, unfortunately. You know what I mean? So I feel like people who have that kind of way about them are just giving people what they're saying that they want, even when they have more to offer.
So saying that, like, mm-hmm. do you feel like you have to, like, I'm not saying dumb down because yeah. I can't apply dumbing down music to an R&B sense. I can yeah. only say that to a rap sense. Do you feel like you have to cut back on your talent and water yourself down just to, like, let's say, be noticed as a talent?
Yeah. I don't want to call it water down because I feel like that's subjective. You okay. know what I mean? Like, we might have a sense of, oh, I love 90s music. I love 80s music. And to that is the bar. Yeah. And other people, especially, you know, much younger generation, like teens and stuff, whatever's going on now is the bar for them. So I don't want to say, you know, water down, but I do feel like you have to tweak your style. I do feel like you have to be on trend to be noticeable, or it's going to be twice as hard. You know what I mean? Or you'd have to be the person that comes in and says, I don't care what's going on right now. This is what I do. And either this becomes the norm, or I'll just do 2-3 shows a year. You know what I mean?
Okay.
That's how I see it.
Now, you know, because Tiny, you know, him being a Capricorn, he's always stuck in his ways. And he always says, this new music, it sucks. Is this? So I appreciate
even the R&B kind of, even the ladies, R&B ladies out here.
It Uh-oh. Depends. It depends.
Like,
it's not like what it used to be.
Tiny's a little choked up. But, you know.
He said no.
So he has to pull up. He has to pull up a seat.
Some of the R&B artists out there, I like brand new artists. Okay. Right. But when it comes to the new artists, it's hip hop.
Okay.
Some of the styles that they, some of the MCs or some of the way they write their lyrics or how they write their lyrics, mm-hmm. I'm not feeling it because you're saying the same thing somebody else is saying. Right now, to me, the music sounds like one continuous track. That's it.
From different people.
Definitely. Right.
It just sounds like one continuous track. There's nobody there to be different.
Yeah.
So when I do hear somebody that got the talent and dare to be different.
Yeah.
Yo, it's kudos. It's not. Yeah, I don't like the garbage that's out there because it's a lot of garbage out there.
Okay, I understand.
And that's just how I feel because I love music. I'm a person that loves music. I'm not one that's going to ride the trend because everybody else is doing it. They thinking it's hot. Come on now.
Come on.
But I give credit to where credit is due. Mm-hmm. You got certain people that I probably don't like, but they have a song that I like.
Yeah.
I give them credit with that.
You know, but I see. I say with that, and I like how open-minded you are to, like, mm-hmm. the up-and-coming young generation of artists coming out, and they have their sound. It's like, I can't say this is their era. It is their era because they're new to the era.
Yeah.
And I guess what they sing about is what they feel.
Yeah.
Because it's, you know, climate, I guess, with the protest and so forth. So, saying that, to young women that are coming up, because this is very important, your message is for young women, little girls. What will be your main message to them if they want to pursue music and how they conduct themselves as an artist, you being experienced? What would be your advice to them?
My advice would be to not try to fit in. And that's hard. That's hard, especially in an age of social media. You feel all this pressure to, you know, kind of be a IG model and popular and have like a million followers.
OnlyFans, like OnlyFans.
A lot of things, you know, a lot of pressure. But in music, there really is a section for you. And I know this because I have a younger sister, you know, and my friends have younger sisters where they'll put, you know, they'll play a song and I'm like, who the hell is this? You know, what is this? You
ridiculous.
Know, and they love it. And they're like, you don't know this person. You don't know this song. And it just goes to show that artist is not for me. I don't dig that artist. I don't even remember the name of the artist, really. That music that they're singing is not what
Boom
I enjoy.
Bop, some shit.
Something.
Who knows?
But my sister's age group love that artist, and if that artist thought to themselves that I can't blend in with, you know, Tank and her and all that stuff, and I'm just not gonna do anything, they wouldn't get to see that there's an age group or a group of people that love them for exactly how they sound and exactly what they do. So that would be my message to young girls, you know, not trying to fit in, just do your thing, because it might take a while, but there is a group of people out there that will rock with you.
You want to know what else messed up the game, too? Auto-tune.
Auto-tune. Oh, no.
Auto-tune.
Everyone's
definitely
scapegoat.
Messed up. Everybody's doing the auto-tune.
Everybody's
so
scapegoat.
If you get them to perform live, you get them to perform live, you will see who the real singers and who's not.
Sounds like they're singing in the shower.
He just, he want to argue right now. So right now.
Oh, boy.
So what I'm going to say is this. See, we talk about spice. Auto-tune. I could mention songs like Computer Love. I could talk about the stuff.
Auto-tune's been around.
Auto-tune's been around. But also, I can say about Milli Vanilli.
Hold on.
Milli Vanilli.
Wait a minute. I wasn't even a Milli Vanilli fan. but let's get this right. One group did the auto-tune. You only talk about Computer Love. One group.
Yes.
We talking about thousands. We talking about who's ever in the industry right now is using auto-tune. Yo, if you using auto-tunes like everybody else, that's why everything is sounding the same.
But are you
that's
talking about rap or R&B?
I'm talking about both.
Because in R&B, I feel like there's levels to auto-tune. Because I don't know of any singer right now that uses auto-tune, and when you go to see them live,
Drake.
They sound... Yeah, well, that's why I said that's
rap. That's harmonizing, though.
That's, you know...
No, Drake is singing, so-called singing.
Well, it's called harmonizing.
But he doesn't
He's
call himself
singing.
A singer, so he gets to... Play around with it like that, you know?
garbage.
Hey, 50 sung a little bit in Ja Rule.
Little bit. Keyword. Keyword, little bit. It's so much of auto-tunes going on out there. Everything sounds the same.
Right.
You understand? So when you do hear a organic sound, somebody that's not using auto-tunes, it stands out. Such as this young lady sitting right now.
I agree. But auto-tune, we could talk about the auto-tune use from like the 2000s, the late 2000s. We could say that. That's kind of... That's back in the day.
There's levels. Because there's no singer that's going to use auto-tune the level that, like, Migos will use auto-tune. Because
Or T-Pain.
Because yeah, it's like a synthesizer. Because it's like that is a specific sound and effect that you're trying to give the listeners. So, but I get what you mean.
Now, 5 years from now, where do you see Teresa Taylor as an artist? And not just an artist, as a writer and as a person.
5 years from now, I see myself definitely writing for other artists, definitely touring the world. I would love to travel the world and perform for people.
Lovely.
Smart.
Yeah. I would love that.
Lovely.
You got that?
So.
Yeah. So, I mean, hopefully in 5 years, I'll definitely still be doing everything that I love doing right now.
Hopefully another virus don't come about.
Because
ain't nobody going to be doing shit.
I know.
I can tell you one
I
thing.
Felt that
you
in my
asked
spirit.
Us in 2015, we'll be doing 5 years from now.
We'd be like on a cruise.
Never mind.
I can tell you one thing. As long as you're singing, as long as you can sing, you're going to be around.
Yeah.
You're going to be around. That's it. Just keep singing.
Thank you.
I'm good now.
So for our listeners, I definitely want to play SOS. I want to play a song.
Everybody's loving that song.
Yes, let's hear it.
Say something. Say something first. This is queued up.
Well, like I said, we're gonna go into the music mix, and we're gonna play both of your songs.
Okay.
Definitely. SOS.
What are they called again? SOS and what?
Say something.
Say something.
So we're going to play both of them, and we'll get right back.
Sounds good.
Uh-oh. So we'll play SOS.
No, not that.
Shout out to Tiny for getting used to using a computer. So, right now.
Is this an Apple? No.
He's definitely got an Android computer. It's time for an iBook. So.
Keep going, man.
Right, so, sorry for the technical difficulties.
Oh, don't say that on there. But it's all right. This is unorganized behavior. We can do that.
Yeah, we can do that. So Sonia, any other questions you'd like to ask?
Yes. Teresa, you had a recent birthday.
Yes.
You know I wasn't going to let that go by.
Ooh,
you had a recent birthday.
Building.
What did you do for your birthday? How does someone like you celebrate?
Well, that's two different questions here.
Oh, boy.
Somebody like me is very extravagant.
Oh, lovely. Tell us about it.
But the way that I ended up celebrating.
Tell us about it.
I just had some friends, do a little gathering. We had, like, a little game night, some drinks, some hookah. It was a good vibe.
That is lit.
Yeah.
Where did that happen?
At a friend's house.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, very nice. Yeah. All right. COVID safe.
COVID safe. Everybody had their mask and stuff.
Oh, lovely.
And then I went out to dinner the next day.
Okay. Yeah, well, we don't usually ask ladies how old they are, so we'll skip that part.
I agree with
but
you.
But she's a young, beautiful woman.
Thank you.
Emphasis on young.
young, beautiful woman, everybody. Definitely.
We're all young, except for Tiny.
Definitely.
You know, I used to feel bad about my age, but you know what?
I'm loving it. There's only one way to not be older, right?
Absolutely.
You still got your hair, though. You still got your line. You still got everything. Yeah. You still solid.
It's still a forehead, not a five head.
Yeah,
not a five head yet.
knowing, it's funny, ironically, a lot of people don't know, we actually know the same person. Mm-hmm. Shout out to Noreen. So I know you
hang... My baby!
So hanging out with Noreen, yo. I know your birthday had to be colorful and it had to be sparkles
she's
everywhere.
She's amazing. She's my energy sister. She knows everything that I need in my life and everything that I love and always makes it happen. So yeah, her being a part of my birthday was definitely magical. As always.
Now, I mean, not even just an artist, though, but, like, mm-hmm. having that tight circle, do you feel like that just helps you even propel yourself more forward? Or, like, in what ways do you feel even helps you in music? Do you get ideas from close friends?
Yeah, it's definitely helpful.
Shout out to Tiny for getting it together. Here is SOS by Teresa Taylor.
Just to say something.
Say something, excuse
no,
me.
No,
this is
SOS.
This is SOS.
Get it together, get it together.
Looking for my hero, but now I have no time for another zero. Give me sweet things and make me feel good. Can you love me?
Love me.
Wanna meet your mama, tell me nice things and bring me flowers. Stay up on the phone and talk for hours, then you put it on me.
On me.
SOS with the up on your chest, just be my Superman and save me, yeah. SOS with the S up on your chest, just be my Superman and save me, yeah. Be my Superman and save me. Be strong for somebody like me.
Like me.
Anything I need you. Right there by my side and I could feel you. Be my lifeline, I wanna need you. Come and save me.
This is Say Something.
So, we just got a good sample of SOS. And, yo, great song. Sorry for the technical difficulties.
That was a lovely song.
Thank you.
Like, what was your influence in creating that song? Because I think that's a great, 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 great radio hit.
Thank you. I really wanted an opportunity to show my Jamaican side, my Caribbean side, without it necessarily coming across as, like, this is reggae music, but something... you know, that kind of blends both of my worlds. Yeah, and so when I was creating the song, the words just kind of came to me. And I felt like, okay, yeah. I think I wrote that song in like 10 minutes.
What? Are you serious?
Yeah.
Man.
Wow.
I wrote Glow in like 10 minutes as well. Yeah, I just, because when I think of something, I just have to do it in that moment.
So it's a fear. And, you know, I'm not very artistic.
Yeah.
I'm on the cusp of Libra, but I'm not that artistic.
Libra. When is your birthday?
21st September.
Okay. Kinda, okay. So I'm not 21st.
So
okay.
I'm
okay.
In between.
Cusp Libra. Got
right
you,
in the
got
end.
You, got you.
So you, you wrote from feeling. Like, yeah. when I'm in the recording studios,
yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And I see, like, different colors. Like, shout out to my boy Nate, Trackformers.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I go in the studio and I'm not really used to it. And I'm like, man, I see orange, I see blue, and I'm like, do you tap into that sense when you write? Like, you see a color or get a smell. Like, I want to get a perspective of someone who's really artistic.
Yeah.
And how is it for you? Like, writing.
I know
music.
People like that was what you're describing. Usually, people who feel like that are people who play an instrument, like piano. They usually kind of get that. There's a name for that. For me, it's definitely a feeling. It's not something that, like, you know, I see colors or I smell things or anything like that. It's more that I could be anywhere. I could be driving, and I'll hear a beat or something. Something will come to me, and I'll literally just have to pull over, write it down, or sing it into my phone. And if anything, I'll get back to it later. But it has to happen in that moment.
That's amazing. It's like... Yeah. you know, you're like so you're a Tupac fan. And of course, big Tupac fan.
Thug life.
So like Tupac used to be like on movie sets and
he would do even the same thing.
Like he would pull over with his notepad and just write, and it's like that has to be another level of creativity.
Yeah.
Like to just to be able to do that.
It's a language.
Yeah, because art is something that can't be forced. I mean, you can't really schedule it. Like you can try to make time and say, you know what, later on I'm going to work on this song. But when that time comes and now you're not even in the vibe, now you don't even remember what you was feeling earlier. It doesn't make sense. So you have to kind of just catch it while it comes to you.
And you know, and when I hear SOS, I get a little Alicia Keys.
Yeah, I get a little Alicia Keys.
Rihanna. Like it's such a crazy blend. It's like you have your own unique style, but it's enjoyable because it's like every single verse I can pick like an artist type of style and be like, wow, like if this is over here, if you understand what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Like, I was gonna say, and I can understand your words.
Yeah.
Which is very nice.
Yeah,
you know, it's actually you're actually telling a story though. Thank you. Know, so I like
Thank
that.
You. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this one definitely is a story out there.
And it's very like, it's like you can play this song in your car.
Mm-hmm.
You can play this song
in the club.
Mm-hmm. In the club,
100%.
A lounge, a barbecue. That's what I like about the movie. It's
and
like
you
very
can sit
translucent.
Down with it,
mm-hmm.
and also dance to it.
Yeah,
actually,
a little twerk, a little sit down twerk.
Yeah.
And for me, I don't dance. Just a little two step.
That's rub about. On your man. Oh, forget it, two step.
Little wine. I see over.
Why you gotta be ratchet?
She's complimenting my wine. Get out of here, yo. Get out of here.
Hate. You know, this is women empowerment.
That's right. That's right.
I'm gonna be quiet. I'm gonna keep Tiny quiet over there with his 1998 laptop. But
he still hasn't updated Windows yet.
Now, so Imaginal, right?
Yeah.
Because before I want to get so your EP, right?
Yeah.
Have you how many EPs have you had before then?
This is my first EP.
Okay, well, for your first EP, it is a very great body of work.
Thank you.
When I met you,
nobody has picked this up yet.
Oh man!
Well,
from
are
your
you
lips,
independent?
I am.
What?
I am.
What is the name of your label?
She's independent.
I'm independent.
It's that age setting it, man. God. No, she's
I'm not signed.
She's not. She's unsigned artist.
No, I know she's don't worry. We'll talk after the mic.
Okay, no problem.
So basically, yeah.
yeah, it's my first EP. Yeah.
Well, the from me hearing it when I met you, like the first thing I do is Instagram is a different thing. I don't like to hear people music from Instagram because it's only one minute.
Yeah.
Just like what you know.
Yeah.
Earlier.
hold on.
Sorry.
Roasting.
You know something?
Roasting the radio station. Damn, Des.
He gonna get this work.
No.
I'm the new Banks. I'm the Banks today.
You the new Banks.
Yeah, he got fired today, but I'm not gonna fire
him. Roasting him.
Yes.
Miss Taylor, my apologies to make up for it. We're going to play this song again.
Okay.
It's called SOS, right?
I got you.
It's the new joint, hot joint. Where can they copy that? Where can they get it?
Everything, everywhere. If you have Spotify, iTunes, Google Play, Tidal, it's literally across all streaming platforms. Yes, it's on
YouTube channel
as well. Yep, TERESA TAYLOR Music.
Wonderful.
The new joint called SOS. By TERESA TAYLOR, aka TT.
I got a nickname, I like that.
Looking for my hero, but I have no time for another zero. Give me sweet things and make me feel good. Can you love me? Wanna meet your mama, tell me nice things and bring me flowers. Stay up on the phone and talk for hours, then you put it on me. SOS, with the S up on your chest. Just be my Superman and save me, yeah. SOS, with the S up on your chest. Just be my Superman.
I'm about to put that S on my chest.
Yeah.
How you want to be saved? I got to know how you want to be saved.
Save the industry.
Someone I can trust, someone I can lean on. Yeah, I feel be kind and yeah, I feel be strong for somebody like me. Anything I need you, right there by my side and I could feel you. Be my lifeline, I wanna need you. Come and save me.
The number is 516.
S-O-S
206-0711.
S up on your chest, just be my Superman and save me, yeah.
Call in, talk to Teresa Taylor.
With the S up on your chest, just be my Superman and save me, yeah.
I can see y'all right now dancing on that wall. I can see y'all right now grinding right now. I see it. Feel that vibe, y'all. Feel that vibe. Teresa Taylor.
Am I doing no good? Tell me, can you be good? Tired of the ballin', so you know me, I be calling.
Let me tell you something.
Woo!
Now that everybody come song, out up here.
That song is official tissue.
Thank you.
That's getting played on 100. My Red Cup Affair. For real.
100.
Thank you.
This is what I'm talking about when somebody stands out when they do music like this. And you know what? The way she took it back, because she went in between. She didn't go all the way. You know what I'm saying? You didn't go all the way, but you just kept it right there. And it's right there on the zone. Now, my question to you now is, do you got a video for this?
No, but a video for that is coming. And for Glow, because Glow was a single I did before I put out this EP, and people have been really loving that song, too, and asking for a video. So the videos are coming, for sure.
Wonderful.
Let me tell you something.
Do you have any videos out yet?
No, not right now, no.
Yo, the minute you do your video, your sales is going to go through the roof.
Views is going to be retarded.
Yeah, the views.
Have you
listening.
Seen her pictures?
Oh, Lord.
So we
that
just
chocolate, smooth skin.
Well, thank you.
In the outfits.
Yo, that, I'm telling you, that song, I'm going to, you know, my family from Alabama, so, you know, I'm going to get my Alabama and my American flag. I'm going on the parkway. Yankee boy.
Oh my
God. I'm wearing my Yankee flag to the parkway because that song right there is definitely
that was the shit.
Enjoyable. And
thank
I wish,
you.
And I'm glad Tiny did play it again. You know, with his 1995 laptop.
No, I couldn't do it injustice like that. No, I wouldn't do that.
No, we don't do that.
I was
that.
Able thank to play you. It again. And people out there, the number is 516-206-0711. If y'all want to talk to Teresa Taylor, please call up. Don't be scared. Don't be nervous.
I don't bite.
You know what I mean? She don't bite. She's looking for that Superman
maybe,
to save her.
Maybe.
She's looking for that SOS, that Superman to save her. Maybe. Y'all heard her.
But you know what? You know what, Ty? Nah, well, I'm not going to make it cut and dry. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. Not everybody can come up here. If you don't have bars as a rapper and you don't have vocal as an R&B singer and you just singing from the nose, because I'm the nose hunter and I don't tolerate that. I'm the urban legend. You can't just come up here. Because a few people came up here and it didn't work out too well.
Oh, no.
It didn't work out too well. So we bring we got the real talent. Right, Tiny? We number one on Boss Goose Radio Network. Number one.
Number one. Now, listen, I see y'all in my room liking it. I see y'all in the room saying it was awesome and everything. I think she would like to hear from y'all. Call up.
Tell her that in person. Get on the phone and call her up so she can hear it.
And cop the single.
That's right.
Don't just watch. Don't just watch. Let's support our artists. Let's support our independent artists. You know, many artists on the forefront trying to, you know, show their talent, you know. So at the end of the day, it's hard work. It's a lot of time in the studio, a lot of time, you know, studio hours, you know. We all work and show our talent, you know, and that's sure. what it should be.
I'd like to say, what kind of performer are you?
In terms of?
Like stage presence, right? Stage presence when you are a new artist is very important. Yeah. Are you a person that dance? Oh, you got a dance routine, or are you a person that's more like laid back in what you're doing and how you're doing? What kind of performer are you?
I mean, it just depends on the song, you know. Like my song Glow, I performed at SOBs, and I had background dancers. And
did you dance?
SOBs. I definitely
that is dope.
Hey. Definitely dance.
Yo, fellas, man, yo, look.
SOBs is on the map.
Yo, yeah. look, I cannot say this again, right? I'm sorry, no, not to be disrespectful. There we go. We got the callers. Y'all stopped me just in time. I was about to jump off the edge.
Unorganized Behavior. This is the Nose Hunter who's speaking.
You got the Grand Imperial, half of the Hot Mouth Morning Show calling in.
Oh, shout out.
Yo, what up, MP? What's good,
shout
my brother?
MP.
What's up, baby? I just wanted to tell y'all I appreciate it, what y'all doing up there, you know what I mean? My lady right there gets busy, you know what I'm saying?
You need to have her on your show. You need to have her come up in the morning on your show.
Come up in the morning. Just bring that, some coffee in the morning with the bagel.
I'm bringing treats.
You definitely in there, and I like what y'all doing. You know, I'm loving the vibe. I'm sitting here up in the Sprinter just watching, tuning in, you know?
You got the big dog vehicle, the Sprinter. Doubt.
Mr. Nose, I respect that name too,
God.
I want to tell you that.
I appreciate it. I appreciate
MP.
Yeah.
Yo.
You know what I'm saying? I'm loving what y'all doing over there, man.
Hold on, MP. Say, thank you. When your show comes on again, man, let everybody know, man, the time slot and when your show come on.
I'll make sure you're tuning in tomorrow. We're going to get it cracking. You know, like eggs and bacon in the morning without the swine, you heard?
Turkey bacon.
I'm 9 to 11 tomorrow, so tomorrow is strictly for the ladies, so. Make sure, ladies, y'all call in. Fellas, call in, too. You know what I'm saying? And the topic, the name of Junior is called What Y'all Want From a Nigga. You know what I'm saying? What y'all want
Sheesh!
From us, we don't really know. You know what I'm saying? So we want y'all to tell us. You know, we don't even go by what we think. We want to go by what we know. You know what I mean?
Y'all know. Sure goodbye. Y'all got two brains. No.
She
said, boy, bye.
No, she didn't say that we know. No. Yeah,
she said, boy,
just
bye.
When we, listen, yeah, just when you think.
Y'all got two heads. Use one.
Listen, no. Just when you think we know, y'all change your mind.
Nah, some dudes are simple-minded.
No. Real talk.
You want hot coffee, you want to call. We want to know. We want to know exactly what y'all thinking. And that's why we open in the form.
Pay attention. Pay attention.
Listen, hold on. Yo, MP, is this true?
I'm definitely attention guy. I pay attention to detail always.
Yeah, me too. Hey, MP. Hey, MP, check this out, right?
So should be no problem.
No. See, check this
right,
out, MP.
Right, Teresa?
I agree.
Hold
up,
no.
Teresa just said there should be no problem, okay? No. She ain't bringing no bagels,
stop
all right?
It.
You providing the bagels, all
no,
right?
No.
She going on your show. She going on your show. You
no matter
the
what you
Teresa,
do,
what
it's going to be a problem.
Teresa, what kind of cream cheese you like, Teresa? That's all I want to know.
Strawberry.
Because he's providing the cream cheese, the bagels,
the nice
and the
one.
Coffee.
Yo, so check
no,
it out.
No, you bringing it.
So check it out.
Truck.
This is what they do, right?
You got to bring it for Teresa.
They tell you they want this man to be in touch with their feelings. They tell you they want this man to be sensitive. They tell you that they want this man to be in tune with their feelings.
So that's not everybody
needs. Hold on. Listen. And the next thing you know, oh, man, that dude too soft, man. I need me a thug. Come on, man.
No.
Queens girls aren't like that.
No. It depends.
Queens girls are different.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
That's just what it is.
Queens women are different.
Y'all tune in tomorrow, man, because it's going to be lit, man, for real.
Absolutely, man.
We're definitely talking about it. What y'all want,
Paul? MP, I'm going to risk getting a write-up at work to tune in. 9 to 11. the nose hunter will sneak and call from the Goldman phone and call in. I'm just gonna act like I'm calling security downstairs.
Yo, yes, man, sir. Yo, don't forget to mention your partner, man. Who's your partner?
Man, this is what we doing, man. Only on Bars and Hoops Radio. Hot Mouth Morning Show. Tune in, baby.
No doubt, man. Thanks for calling.
Always.
Yes, sir. Now, since we're all in our feelings right now, I want to go into the song Say Something. Is
yes.
that okay?
Let me hear another
is
song.
That, is that okay?
Yeah. I want to hear another
let's
song.
Let's see a place. Let me get over
here. Enough of this nonsense.
What nonsense you talking about?
No, but it's not. Tiny, just play the song, Tiny.
Yeah.
Tiny, you play.
Always
Tiny,
trying to beef with me, Tiny.
Tiny, you play the song, because I got, you know, speaking about ghetto devices, I don't.
Oh, hold up, man. You got to play it from your end over there.
I'm trying to shake it over here.
What's the matter? It's not playing?
No.
What phone do you got?
Don't worry about it.
Whether you just talking about an iPhone.
Don't worry about it.
You were just in the droids just a second ago, right?
Don't worry about it.
It's got to be a 2020 droid, Tiny.
Oh my goodness. Go into something real quick. Let's go into something.
Teresa, how about this, Teresa? All right. Yeah. Can you give us something on the mic right now?
Sure.
Can you give us something a cappella right now? That's what I like to hear. I like to hear live.
All right. Cool. What y'all want to hear? You got a request off the EP?
What's the song
I
that
see
we
y'all
trying
like
to hear
SOS.
Right now?
You like SOS?
I was going to say something, but we
just heard SOS?
Yeah.
Y'all going to play Say Something?
Yeah, he's going
to
play Say
Something. I'm going to try to get my technical difficulties. I was on. Tiny cursed me.
Let me ask you something. Do you sing over hip-hop beats? Do you sing over, like, instrumental tracks?
Yeah. All
right, let's hear you.
But I could sing Say Something for you guys. That's a nice...
Yes.
Chill vibe.
Okay. I want to hear something else besides what we're going to play.
Okay. You got to play
something. That would
something.
Be nice.
Okay. Have y'all heard Only One?
No.
No.
All right. We're going to go into Only One.
Do we got a beat for her? Or?
For acapella
she's
it is.
She's taking it.
My joint is still acting up, y'all. I'm sorry.
She's taking it.
Hold on.
Yes, acapella it is. And
be too fast, let me
know. Here we go. Can I do Only One to this? Can I rock with this? All these other people that want you, all these people that want you mine. Tell me, are you willing to give them what I consider to be mine? I don't want to feel like I'm on you. I ain't trying to mess up your grind. And even when you're out with your homies, I'm not insecure, but I just want to be the only one you give your heart to, the only one that you can hold to, the only one that always calls you, always stays on your mind.
Remix.
Tell me how that can be me. Tell me how that can be me. All I want from you is attention and affection and your time. Ooh. Tell me how that can be me. All I want from you is attention and affection and your time.
Teresa Taylor.
That was hard to do on that beat.
AKA TT.
TNT, don't explode. Don't explode in the building.
Tiny, cut the music.
Don't explode.
Cut the music.
Whoa.
Cut the music, goddammit. Cut the music, goddammit. How do we have an R&B artist come up here with fire? Off the dome. And it's better than some of these rappers out here.
Not even that. She adjusted to it.
She adjusted.
Damn right.
Song. I'm like,
damn right.
But it was dope. That was dope.
It was dope.
Did you see the adjustment?
That was a Mayweather
adjustment. That was a counterpunch. That was a pull counter.
That was a nose hunter punch.
But see, that's what I'm talking about.
Yes.
Artists, from now on, when you come up, if you can't rock to a beat that I put up, I'm kicking you out the building.
Damn right.
Straight up. You getting kicked out the building. If I throw a beat on and you stuck froze talking about, I can't rock to this. Get up. Get out your seat. Get out. That's what's going on right now.
On air.
And she did it with R&B. Not even rap. She made a transition. That was a pull counter to Mosley's nose and the escape out to the side.
That shit was super impressive. I'm not even lying right now. That shit was really...
You know what, Tiny? I have to say this.
That shit was really
amazing. I got on you a little bit earlier.
Send him a bouquet, all right?
Your computer is Android. My phone's Android. I have to say that. That was my thing. Uh-oh. You know, I might have to go step into the Apple world. I'm sorry, Pop the bearded one of Gutter Ball Rally, other partner here.
Yo, I want her to sing again.
Man. I think so too. Do you mind?
No. Sure.
Can you do one more time?
This song, the same song?
No. I'm going to look for something different.
Let's just try a cappella. How about that? We put enough pressure on her.
I liked it with the beat too. I think that brings you up another level just because of the adjustment factor that you had to just.
I'm going to really test
attach
her.
Yourself
I'm
to.
I'm going to really test her.
Oh damn! Don't listen. We already sweating here, okay?
See, now I got to do something that y'all already played though.
Take it away, Teresa. Fuck
here
everything.
Here we go.
Looking for my hero. And I have no time for another zero. Give me sweet things that make me feel good. Can you love me? Love me. Wanna meet your mama. Tell me nice things and bring me flowers. Stay up on the phone and talk for hours. And you put it on me. SOS. With the S up on your chest. Just be my Superman and save me.
What y'all know about that?
Hold on.
Sick.
We got Tiny stuck back in the day.
Unbelievable.
Jeez, where's this Kango at?
Yo, the number one show on Bars and Hoops Radio. This is Unorganized Behavior. Y'all see how we do. That phone should be ringing off the hook right now. 516-206-0711. This is what real singers do. This is what they really do. They get on that mic. They sing, and they let you know what it is. This ain't no ringtones. I'm sorry for all y'all ringtone rappers.
Popeye's commercial.
You know what I'm saying? This is not no auto-tunes. I'm sorry for all y'all auto-tune singers.
Definitely not. We did not adjust the mic.
This is Teresa Taylor. Y'all need to go. Where can they go look? They can find you. You said all platforms.
All major platforms.
What's your Instagram,
Teresa? My Instagram is Teresa Taylor Music. Follow me. You'll get updates on everything that I'm doing. iTunes, Spotify, Tidal. I'm on YouTube Music. You can find me everywhere.
How many songs on your EP that
six.
You have?
Six. Six. Songs? Okay. Six.
Yo.
That was really lovely. And for a music video, what are you thinking for your music videos?
You're going to have the Bars and Hoops family on there, right?
Yes.
You're going to have the Bars and Hoops family on there.
For sure. I'm still working through concepts because I want to do a video for Glow as
Glow.
Well.
Glow is fire.
Thank you.
I heard Glow. Glow is definitely fire.
Thank you.
It takes me to the house.
Place. Yes. Yeah, like definitely.
House music. Definitely.
Yeah, I try to, for every song on my EP, I try to give it a little bit of a different flavor for everybody who... Some people love that neo soul vibe, that R&B vibe.
I love the neo soul.
Right. Some people like the house thing, the dance hall thing. So I try to sprinkle a little bit for everybody. But for the video, I'm still working through concepts for both of them. Yeah. But I definitely would love for you guys to be a part of it.
Are you writing the treatment and everything? You already got the people lined up?
I would because I'm so used to writing everything by myself. Right. But I'm open to people who are like, I have an idea. You know,
Tiny was in a Public Enemy video.
I wasn't just in the video. I was down with them. You got to get this straight.
Ooh. I know you're square. Ooh.
I
know you.
I was
square.
There.
Didn't I was. Go. I just got there in '87.
Okay, coming
but,
back.
But it's
coming
all
back.
Good though. It's all good. But yeah. Fellas, I do got to reiterate this. Y'all can go to my Unorganized Behavior Facebook page. Where you can see everybody that's talking and you can see their faces and everything like that.
This woman, Teresa Taylor, is a very beautiful woman.
Oh, thank you so much.
Very beautiful. Yo, listen, I'm talking about inside and out.
Thank you.
She got the type of body to make brothers run into a tree.
So come correct.
That's right.
Hey, hey.
You're going to crash when you see
Keep
this.
Keep it PG, Tiny.
It is PG.
Be civilized. Don't act like you're in front of your building.
But all jokes aside, though, she's definitely got the talent. She got the look. She got the whole package. I will be seeing you in the future. And when you do hit that platinum, please come back to us.
I will.
Please come back to us.
I will.
You freestyling now just from singing.
Yeah.
You ever thought about rapping? Because some R&B artists in the past have rapped. They've dipped into rap and didn't do bad. We talked about rap.
I think you would do good on that.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Tory Lanez is one artist that dipped into rap that can actually rap pretty well. Chris Brown can rap pretty well.
Yeah, for sure.
I think that you ever considered that?
I have to say, Tory Lanez is
mess
a beast.
Mess around with it. Yeah.
All jokes aside, I give him credit. Yo, he's a beast when it comes to that lyrical rapping
skills. Yeah,
for
sure.
I gotta give him props on that.
For sure.
But he's still a punk ass.
Teresa, tell him your Instagram again, Teresa.
Teresa Taylor Music. That is my Instagram. Follow me for all the updates. My music, my regular schmegular life, everything. You get everything on that page.
Yes, I looked at your Instagram. I noticed a very lovely picture of you in a carnival outfit.
Oh, yes.
How did you get to participate in that?
I started participating in Brooklyn. It was so many years ago. I think I played carnival like for 6 years. I've played also in Miami and in Jamaica.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I don't even remember how I got started. I probably just, one of my friends put me onto a band that like sells the costumes. And then I started to model for them when I was much slimmer. And
Stop.
See how skinny Sonya is?
I need to gain some weight, shit.
So that's how I kind of got into that.
That was a lovely picture.
Thank you.
I love you in gold.
Thank you.
Gold color.
Thank you.
We're gonna go for like a little quick music mix break. Tiny's got his computer working pretty well.
Oh,
and
my
I'm so
goodness.
Excited. I feel like a kid on Christmas Day. And when we come back, we're gonna, you know, if you do you mind that you get to talk about our topic that we have today? Okay. Perfect.
To everybody who knows my soul, to all of those who came before me, my time is up, I'm gonna do it all over again. Ain't nothing, no way, nothing changed, I'm still gonna do it my way. And I still remember me by your Vice behind me on the intersection. Sex and drugs, my anthology on perfection. Dressed superb, admired by conspirers who wanna try me, but ain't high enough to full fire me up. Child of the 80s, y'all niggas is lazy. Complain about labor pains, niggas show me the baby. Then my nigga came, light another L, pass the bottle. Pro black, alpha cotton, out of aspirin bottle. Yeah, I learned my lessons and heard y'all snitching. Witnessing you rocking with Nas confirmed my suspicion. Green fatigues on, my niggas I bleed for them. I can show them the water, but can't make them drink it. And I can show them my fortunes, but can't force them to think rich. And still I don't abort them when and if they stay quick. Ignore the ignorance. I rep the brilliance of Queensbridge and pray the fans let know the England. To everybody who knows my strong, to all of those who came before me, the time is up. I'm gonna do it all over again. Ain't nothing gonna wait. I'm still gonna do it my way. And I still remember me by your page. Oh, no, I'm lost. I could just be by your page.
I don't talk about my guns, nigga, I just play.
This time I do it, I just be
by your page. biggest watching, biggest listening. While fun talking to his jam, Jay still spinning. To every nigga listening, I was supposed to be amongst kings. My mom shouted out at my christening. And why you still listening? Shine locked in a manhole. Cam got shot inside his Lambo. Example, life is a gamble. 15 years old, wear rag around my head. My sisters used to laugh and call me Rambo. Seen Easy's legacy melt away like a candle. I rekindled the flame, Dre created the game. Nigga with an attitude from the cloth I came. Young homie ate his way up from the bottom of the food chain. Keep the crown, clown. I rock a L.A. Dodger fitted. Show my ass that summer jam, but New York was down with it. Now the boss in my court, never dribble out of bounds with it. Behind the back, the knives, the alley, you the jigger, nigga.
To everybody who knows my soul, to all of those who came before me, my time is up, I'm gonna do it all over again. So ain't nothing going, nothing changed, I'm still gonna do it my way. And I still remember when we find you
and it's a classic, trust me. How you pass the Dutchie to them niggas that don't love me? I'm talking niggas that never wanted to see me on top. Same niggas that never wanted to see the doctor's advocate drop. Flop, I think not. I fuck you rap niggas like virgins. Dre took my training with those office curtains. I don't need no encore, no claps, no cheers. The game ain't over, this is the beginning of my career. The ending of yours, the ending of his. Like Flavor Flav's clock, I'm back to handle my biz. Niggas, game time, that was Dre's favorite line. Back when Proof was in the booth and I recited his lines. And I still think about my nigga from time to time. Make me wanna call 50 and let him know what's on my mind. But I just hold back, cause we ain't beefing like that. He ain't big and I ain't Pac, and we just eating off rap. One love.
To everybody who knows my story, to all of those who came before me, time is now, I'm gonna do it all over again. Somehow, ain't nothing going, nothing changed, I'm still gonna do it my way. Yeah, I still remember every time you hate your game. Oh, no, I'm lost, I could just be hurt. Every time you hate your game. Oh, 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 oh,
I go by the name of the one and only, Just Blaze. I got a couple people in the house with me. Usually we do this at the beginning, but we don't do it at the end this time. I want to take them to church real quick. So I'm going to need some help. I need some people up. I need 1500 or nothing up here with me. We're running through town to Marsha Ambrosius, Flow with you. All right, yeah, there we go. The sun is shining down on us right now. We're feeling real good. We know y'all do too. So if you're feeling good, sing along, clap along, stomp along, catch a little Holy Ghost. If you ain't feeling good, God willing, by the end of this record, we gonna change all that. Hey, on the ranch, you ready? There it is. Pass me them drumsticks. All right, everybody, please join in. Your life ain't good. You need to get it right. We'll take this opportunity to do so. And, but let's do what it do. Rest in peace, George Elliott. Here we go.
Yeah.
Talk to y'all. See? On Sunday, we got Renegade Radio. Shout out to Squeak, which comes on 11 to 1. After that, it's the flagship show, Bars and Hoops Radio, which comes on 4 to 6. And coming back this Sunday, Kids Talk TV. Make sure y'all tune in this Sunday, Kids Talk TV, which comes on from 7 to 8:30. We also got a new DJ coming. He's going to be starting at 9 to 10. That's just on Sunday. Then we go to Monday. Little bit of sunshine. From 7 to 9. Then you go to Tuesday. Unorganized Behavior. The number one show on Bars and Hoops Radio. 8 to 10. Tune in tomorrow for DJ JOJ. Wednesdays. From 9 to 11. Feature Phenom. Gotta check it in. And on Thursdays. Yes, yes. On Thursday,
AB Boxing featuring Antonio and GT, the best boxing news in New York City and the best boxing news in America and in the world.
Oh, and I forgot to say, immediately after this show, Bars and Hoops will be coming on. Check out for their update on sports and hip-hop. Immediately after this show at 10 o'clock, do not turn off the dial. Make sure you listen. Now we're going to go to Friday, where we got Goddess of Frequency. She comes on at 7 to 8. And then from 8 to 10, we had the iCast featuring Stills the Great, Ali Vegas, and Edie. Saturday, the debut, the grand opening of Rally Radio Show.
Shout out to Pop the Bearded One.
Featuring Pop the Bearded One, which is coming on from 12 to 1:30. After him, we landed on Planet Neptune, which is 2 to 4. We got a new DJ coming in them slots. DJ Wu, what up? I see you.
Shout out to Wu.
At 7 o'clock on Saturday, it's BR Design. I mean, my bad. DJ Sherman. DJ Sherman from 7 to 8. Then after him is BR Design with the Caribbean spices, the Caribbean flavor. And right now, you are tuned in to Unorganized Behavior featuring Dez.
No, honey.
And featuring Sonya with our special guest Teresa Taylor.
And we have another special guest. Please.
Wait. wait. Hold on. Let me turn this down. Because we got another special guest in the building. What is her name?
You can call me Anika Love.
Anika Love is in the building.
Woo!
This is what goes on the number one
Anika
show.
Anika Love, too. Oh, Anika Love. Oh, sorry.
That's right. Oh, you need some love. Okay. I like the way she did a spinoff on that.
So I want to go into tonight's topic, and we're on our grown-up BI right now, grown-up business,
of course. You know. Oh, shit.
We got to behave ourselves, Tiny. We outnumbered. Tonight's topic is...
I'm not outnumbered.
Oh, he'll take his jacket. Okay, he's flexing right now.
All
okay.
right, we're going to have to take him down, ladies. We're going to have to take him down.
Tonight's topic is financial education. Okay. How did you see money growing up, being from the inner city, compared to what you know now? And what is your idea about money, investing, and so forth?
Can I put a spin on it?
Yeah, put a spin on it.
Financial education is the difference between how the white family teaches their kids how to handle money, or difference between the black family on how they teach their kids to handle money. This is why it's so deep with financial education. Because see, at a young age, their families are teaching them how to invest money. They're teaching them how to handle money. They're teaching them how to open up an account. They're teaching them how to take out loans. They're teaching them how to use their money to make it grow. Whereas we, as black people, I'm guilty of it too. We tell our kids, yo, you gotta go to college. You want a better job, you go to college. You get a better job that way. You work hard, you go to college. But after that, then what? You're not teaching them how to use money. You're not teaching them how to spend money. You're not teaching them how to make money or have your money make money. No. This is the difference between how we taught our kids and everything.
And you
like
know,
that.
Tiny, you know, you old school at noon. So, you know, back in your day, it was all check cashing and mattresses. Back in the day, you used to store your money in the mattress like back in the day. You know, before the bank accounts.
I think that was
a lot of our, you know, things we used to do back in the day. Not me, you know.
Yeah, but when you're not used to, bring your did you hit the red button?
Yep.
Okay. All right. Everybody loud and clear? Okay, good. All right. What's up, Zai? Thanks for tuning in, Zai. I see you. All right. Here's the question, right? What have your mother taught you about using money or making money?
Nothing. I mean, like, honestly, it's like when you grow up, our parents, you know, your generation X, right? So you're the first of the latchkey kids, right? The kids that had the key to the house. You had to stay home as a kid. You babysat yourself, right? Correct? So basically, you was pretty much self-taught things. So I was raised the same way she was raised. And it was kind of like, you better just get to school. I'm going to work. And everything you need to learn is going to be at school. Because you can't teach what you don't know, correct? Right?
Absolutely.
So me going outside as a youth, I mean, I saw the drug dealers. I saw, you know, people, you know, made money in different ways. Some legal, many illegal. And I didn't know about a bank account. I'm going to tell you, my first time ever having a bank account, I was 18. You know, now you see kids now, they're like 15 years old. Their parents have joint bank accounts, you know.
I made sure all my sons got bank accounts now. I've been making sure of that. Because, like you said, if we don't do it, we don't teach them. They're never going to learn. They're going to be spending money frivolously. If you're in this real silly life. You know
like
what I'm saying?
Well, school doesn't teach financial education either. So who is at fault? The system or the parents?
The system.
Ooh.
Say that again. I like what she said.
A little bit of both.
My mom, I'm just now learning how much is left on the house, interest rate, this and that.
Exactly.
It's
mortgages, it's all of that. You don't learn that.
It's a lot. Not in our country.
Like I said, back to storing money in the mattresses and not trusting the bank. Like, that's like a lot of World War II, you know, depression ways that I still see people to this day. Like, you'll be surprised how many people are scared to get a bank account. Like, mm-hmm. you know, like, I've seen people like, yeah, you know, walk around with $2,000 in their back pocket. Like, yeah. you know, still going to the check cashing place. Like, you know, yeah. and basically, you know, hoping that no one steals their
paying
money.
Paying that fee.
Paying that. What's
that fee to cash it. I don't know, 10%? No, 3%.
I'm saying some places might be 10% too, especially a place where you gamble.
So, yeah, all right, so here's the question I'm going to put out there, right?
Sure, Tony.
Okay, now the question is right now, is saving money a good thing or a bad thing?
Saving money is always a good thing.
Yeah, I don't see how it could be bad.
Now, saving money compared to investing, right? So people say, if you want to get rich, right? People say, well, do you save money or do you invest money? Like many people who are like wealthy, right?
Right.
For instance, I mean, our incompetent president that we have is a key example of never saving anything, but he's always investing and making a living. So what do you guys, like growing up, what was your definition? I want to start with you, Teresa, and go forward. What's your definition and how you were taught growing up of what investing was from a childhood?
But was she even taught investing?
Well, we're going to see.
I mean, I wasn't really... We didn't have much financial conversation like that in my, you know, younger days. But I think, like, for my parents, their idea of investing is usually property. You know, they own homes.
But that's a good investment, though.
Yeah, like, that's how they... That's how they've always...
You're always going to need a place to live.
Right. You know what I mean? So that was their thing for sure. We never really had a conversation of like, you know, learn how to flip money and invest in this and that. Because it wasn't something that was going to get you rich real fast. So
that's a lot better than when I was growing up. Yeah. Man.
Now, the reason I posed that question about saving money, right? It's like this. Your money's not making money. You're saving, but it's not making money. Hold on, turn that down. We're getting a lot of feedback. The two gray buttons at the back, turn it down. There we go. All right. So here's the thing. I'm going to give you an example. I give you $500.
Yes.
Right? You take $500.
500.
500.
That's how I grew.
Right? Now you're working. You make another 250. But you take that 500 okay. that I gave you and you save it. Right, you save it. So right now you're just dealing with your 250.
Okay.
Now you take your 250, and you paid your bills. Now you're broke, but you're not really broke because you feel that you saved that $500. So right. what you do, you start going into that little bit of money you were saving, and now it's decreasing. It's not making nothing. It's decreasing. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, I spent my Trump $1,200.
No, but
well, we supposed to be getting a second one.
Right. But see,
where's it at, Trump?
Right. But see, what I'm saying is, your money's not making money. To invest, you really want to invest your money. That's where you're gonna make money.
Yeah,
saving is good.
A lot of people say invest, but invest into what? And what's the return? And how soon? People have the idea of, I would like to invest in something, but within at least a year or two, I can see money. When you invest in a lot of things, you're getting 50 cents interest. You're getting money that is like
CD accounts and stuff like that. Yeah.
That's not, you're not going to see that money until you're ready to retire.
No.
In order to invest in something that's going to give you a real return, you have to have a lot of money to do that.
No, you don't.
You see the diversity?
No, you don't. You don't have to. You got to start off with at least $1,000 is not a lot of money.
Okay.
Right? You can start off with $1,000 and you can invest in the stock market. There is some places where you can invest and your return will come back quick.
But you can also lose. But if you don't have cushion money.
Hold on. But you got to do your homework. You have to do your homework in that. And a good person to talk about the stock market is Pop the Bearded One. Shout out to Pop the Bearded One. He does his research to a point.
The beard, wisdom.
To a point, he got it down to a science where if he tell you, yo, you know what? This is the next thing to blow up into you. Yo, do that. And I'm going to tell you right now, at this moment, it's the best time to start looking into them stocks because everything is getting hit. to the point.
Yeah, it's going
to
crash again.
Right.
Yeah.
No, no. But everything is getting to the hit. And anytime that anything gets to the bottom, they got to go up because they already hit the bottom. Now it's going to, you know, they're going to start to go up.
Yeah.
So you got to pay attention and invest. Trust me.
Also, you know, I'm going to play devil's advocate once again. I know what our problem is. As a community, I know what it is.
What?
It's too much chicken.
It's them goddamn lottery tickets. It's them lottery tickets. Let me tell you something. How many people?
Oh my goodness. I know a lot of people that play these scratch offs.
So let me, it's not even scratch offs, right? I had a friend.
I love scratch offs.
I had a friend. Oh my God. It's the same thing with people down south. It's close by. It's close enough.
I love scratch offs.
So like people play numbers, right? And when I was 18, I gambled, right, with the stock market. I learned how to trade ETFs and stuff like that. I took $1,200 and I made $500 profit in about 4 months. Mm-hmm. Not liquid, right? Not really that liquid, right? But I see people know this lottery system. They're like, dollar box this and this.
Yeah.
I'm like, the terminology, you need a whole book to figure out what they're talking about when they're saying it. And I'm just trying to get a sandwich.
Well, look.
For real.
I'm guilty.
I'm just trying to get a big nigga
to you. I'm guilty of winning $25,000.
I know, because you're part of that generation. Winning. Wait, well, you want lottery?
I'm guilty of winning $25,000.
Well, how much did you spend?
$5.
$5
straight, dollar box. $5 straight, dollar box.
Well, how much money did you spend to win that $25,000?
See, look. No, no, hold on.
Oh, damn.
Yes, I did invest
it. Came from the round corner.
Anika, I did
invest it. Tiny, did you invest it?
Yes, I did invest. Now, hold on. Let me break this down to you.
Yeah, let me break it down.
I wasn't the type to play it every day. People that play every day, they put too much in it. I was the type, whenever I had extra money, I played. So if I felt like I felt lucky, I played only one day.
That's your generation problem.
No, one day, and I did it, right? So I just happened to get a new car. I seen the license plate, and I ran with the license plate.
You got the 88 Saab.
Right?
Perfect.
$5 straight, dollar box. You know, $5 straight, dollar block, 1713. I ain't going to never forget that number. And I hit it.
Let me tell you something, Tiny.
Yeah.
Also, too. And I'm, you know what? Those lottery tickets, those cigarettes, those are things that we invest our money into. Think about it. Look, Tiny, remember back in the day?
I don't smoke.
No, you don't smoke. Nobody in here smokes cigarettes, hopefully not. But, you know, with cigarettes, right? They raised a pack of cigarettes from back in the day. It was like $5 back in the day, something like that?
No.
That's about like 20 years ago.
Cigarettes used to be 60 cents.
Oh, wow. So 60 cents, right?
60 cents.
And what's a pack today? Like... $13, right?
Absolutely.
60 cents.
So if you smoke a pack,
Tiny, you that old?
Smoke it 3 days, right?
I'm breaking it down.
So let's break it down, right? You smoke a pack, right? Two packs a week, because some people do, right? That's $26. Now you multiply that by 10 weeks, right? That's $260. So now you add some lottery tickets. I seen people get their check the 1st and 15th. Them lottery tickets are like drugs. Like you see them, you see them in the store. Yo, I seen someone
Hold on. Let me break this down to you. Now, you see what you just said, right?
Yes, sir.
That's a creature of habit. That was their habit. That's what they was into. What you're into. You're into motor cars. You're into getting motors. Anything dealing with cars and you want to get, you spending money to get that.
Hey, I drive a Volvo, okay?
No, but regardless of the fact, that's what you're into.
Yeah,
it's modified, but what you're into is what you're spending money on. You understand what I'm saying?
So
wait a minute. Where do that return come from of you spending your money on those parts? Where does the return comes in?
Because I can street race and make my money.
Oh, but, come on, man. Think about that.
Racing. You could resell parts.
I was going to say, you could add
I can sell my car. I can sell it. Yeah. Like, you know, I mean.
It'll be less like,
no, I have a classic car. I have a 91 Super.
What I'm saying, I'm giving you an example.
Agree.
You can't use what people are into or saying that they're spending their money because it depends on what you're into. Guess what? The cigarettes cost $13.
It's our
motor cost. The motor costs $400. At least.
Yeah. All right, just add a couple zeros on that.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's even worse.
But no, but like, but what I'm saying, Tiny, I'm going to say, look, this. It's our fault.
Mm-hmm.
It's our fault. Look, materialism, right? How many times you see a kid in a stroller with a pair of Jordan 5s on? This kid has a Jordan collection and can't even walk. You know what my mother bought me when I was a kid? I was born in 87. My mom used to buy me the little shoes with the wood bottom on it so I could learn how to walk. Like, these look like some Daffy Duck, some type of, like the shoes, because, like, there were shoes made to help a baby walk. Wearing a pair of Jordan 12s and you can't even hold your neck up, what's the point? You know, like think about it. Imagine if we, like, Tiny, imagine we got reparations, right?
Yeah.
40 million of us, right? Born in America. And they give out, and they say, $40 million. We're going to give everybody $1 million. Do you know how much money would go back to the economy? We would probably make a surplus economy. Tiny, we all know shopping. How many pairs of Jordan. Dudes would have Jordan, a blanket made with Jordan.
Yo, listen, I'm going to the houses and cars.
But see, you mature, right? We're all mature adults in this room. How many people, like when the Chappelle skit, the dude bought the whole cool cigarette truck, right? Yeah. And
they gave it out to everybody.
He's like, nah, I ain't stop quit driving this truck. I'm gonna do that. Dudes will go and buy, like, yeah, I'm telling you, the stock for Range Rover and Aston Martin and Rolls Royce was skyrocketing. You know how many people would buy a $450,000? Because you know what it is? We see people on entertainment, like, I'm in boxing, right? So I know fighters, and all these fighters want to be Mayweather. They want to fight like him, even they don't got reflexes and good legs. You know, they want to try to do Mayweather and shoulder roll and all that stuff. But they also want that lifestyle. Now, what we fall into, like I said, creature of habit, everything, we're very visual and we're very amplified emotional people. So think about when he was a kid, right, in school, right? What's the first thing you did? Your generation is different. Yeah, I mean, y'all was spinning on boxes and stuff and listening to Cool and the Gang and all that stuff, right? But I went to high school in the 2000s.
Yeah, you know what? I'm not going to take I'm not going to take too much more of them old jokes. All right?
Well, Banks is I'm the only one left.
No, I'm not going to take too much of them old jokes. So I think I suggest you stay in your little boy's pants while I spank you. All right?
I graduated in 05.
And I'm not even saying pause either. All right, let's get that straight. So, hold up. I got a question before you even go on.
Yes, sir.
We are talking about financial education.
Yes.
What good advice you can give somebody that has money or came into a
for the dumb things that I've done in my past and blowing thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars on shoes, doing motor swaps that cost $5,000. I mean, just materialism. My advice to them would be start off young, because when I was trading the stock market, I was doing different things and whatever. I didn't keep going. What I did is said, oh, wow, I make $200 today. I'm going to buy me a pair of premium Tim's. I'm going to go to Grand Gus Mall. I'm going to buy me a pair of Tim's. I'm going to go buy me a pair of Air Force. Back then, it was like, you know, Air Force. Everybody was baggy back then. So I had my, you know, snowman shirt on and Robins and all that stuff, you know. Focus on more of the end goal of your life and what you want. Invest in intellectual property. For instance, like we're co-owners of the station, right? Right? Partial owners. That's something that we can take with us, right? But I can't take away them goddamn Tims. I trained a kid that was born in 2009. I have some Tims in my room from 09.
I'm confused.
Make smarter decisions and think about your future. That's what I'm saying.
All right. Teresa, Taylor, what would you advise your advice to? That you would give to people that came into some good money?
Do a lot of research, because there's things that no one is really gonna tell you. You know what I mean? Information people aren't really going to give you. I think people are usually really vague, especially like when people say invest and things like that. I would say to find out what you're interested in, so that way you don't fall off, like how you were saying, where I did this, I made some money, and then I moved on, bought some things with it. That's because you just were just putting some money up in the air and hoping for a return, as opposed to
make
saying,
it rain.
Yeah, as opposed to saying, like, I like real estate, so I'm gonna invest in property, or I like stocks, so I'm gonna do that. Like, find what it is you can see yourself continuing to be interested in, and use your money towards that.
And stay out, and men stay out them goddamn strip clubs.
Same thing goes to
I was I felt like a total bozo.
No, we're not gonna pass you. We're gonna do you some of your
I was just giving you attention, Tiny.
Okay, I like that attention.
I'm gonna say something. I went to my first strip club at 30 years old. I felt like a complete bozo in there. Yo,
you invested your money in ass. Straight up, that was an investment.
I felt like I seen the regular locals that was there, and you knew it was payday. It was payday, the Saturday after payday, right? Yo, dudes was at the bar with $1,000 plus, $2,000, $3,000, $4,000. I was pissed. I blew $300. I said, I felt like an asshole.
Oh, no.
That because you was 30 and you was wide open over the girl you fell in love with. That's what happened.
No, I was at a bachelor. It was actually a bachelor. It was my boy. It was actually like a bachelor
that's
celebration. It was
sing
a bachelor celebration
sing
with a pro wrestler.
See, you was an amateur.
See,
if you spent $300 that first night, you was head over heels. You never seen women like that in your life, and you just went crazy. That's what
it
happened.
It was like 25 of them. We was on Queens. We was in Astoria. Like, it was like...
Hold on, before we go.
I smell like hookah and Bath right. and Body Works.
Before we go over, let's ask Sonya Blade, what kind of advice would you give people on how to deal with money?
Oh, excuse me. Okay. All right, on some real shit.
Oh, hood, yeah.
Financial.
Shout out to QB.
On some real shit. On some real shit. Financial freedom takes many, many years. And it's a common misconception that you're gonna do something and it's gonna flip right away, and it really doesn't work that way. Shout out to Napoleon Hill. Napoleon Hill's Think and Grow Rich. This is a really good book. If you're not interested in reading, you can listen to it on YouTube. It's about 10 hours long. But you can hear all the secrets and tips on working on your personality first, because it really depends on your personality. If you're not committed, if you're a person that gets frustrated, if you're a person that complains all the time, then you're not really gonna surpass a certain level of success. Also, you have to build up a financial portfolio, which means that you have to have multiple avenues of income. So you don't need a lot of money to start these things off, but you do need to save your money in order to do something with the money. If you want to save the money and you feel like your money's just sitting there and you ain't doing something with it, shout out to Capital One Bank. Because Capital One Bank has the highest interest rates among local banks right now. The more they have interest rates for all of their accounts, any account, every single account, they have an interest rate of some sort. And the more money you have in the account, the higher the interest rate goes up. It goes up. So you have $5,000, you get a certain amount. You got $10,000, you got a certain amount. And so if you're a person that doesn't want to invest, is afraid to lose your money, and just wants to save your money, then you can invest in these other accounts that will give you your money back. And multiple avenues of income is really the goal. Have something working on you, have your money working for you, and then be working on something else.
Now, do you mind if you tell our listeners, Sonya, like maybe one avenue that you might have invested in?
Sure. So real estate is a good one. Like Teresa mentioned earlier, you always need a place to live, and others always need a place to live. So they'll always be looking for you to live at your place. You can rent out your place and have renters pay your mortgage for you. Also, again, as I said, shout out to Capital One. You can have accounts there, CD accounts. They have interest rates that are upwards of 2% and more. So if your money is just sitting there and you have a certain amount of money, you can make a couple of $100s in 1 year. I don't see why not.
And also, too, I could say don't treat your business like a hustle. Don't take a dope boy's mentality into business and the mattress mentality into business. Every business is not a hustle.
False.
It has to be a passion. It's a passion.
False.
It's a passion.
That's false.
You have
statement.
To have a passion.
Jay-Z, hustler, dope man.
He's a businessman and he's consistent.
Sean Combs. Sean Combs. Sean Combs. P. Diddy, hustle man.
He hustled, but he had a
damn near billion dollar man.
But listen to what I'm saying. He hustled, but he had a structure and he had a passion.
No,
don't treat it as a pure hustle.
But he took the streets with him to do it. It took him to know how to move in the streets for him to make those moves.
But Jay-Z can move in a corporate setting as well with consistency and a plan.
But he took it from the streets.
He might have took some elements, but
I'm just saying that young statement you just made as a young man was false.
It was not false. Yes. Why it wasn't false? Because they had structure.
Hold on, let's go to
the street to sell dope.
Let's go to Tanika Love. I need love.
Yes.
What's your advice on financial education?
I need some myself. I'm still learning.
Talking to the mic.
I would say invest in yourself. Touching on what the lady said,
Absolutely.
Like, because if you want to invest in all these things, but like you have no knowledge of it, you need to do the work. Like, you need to do the classes, you need to your research. And that's an investment in itself. So I would say, and then invest in the future, because like them kids need to learn. You can't complain that they don't know what they're doing if no one's helping them.
Now, what makes a great, let me ask you guys one question all together. What makes a good craftsman or a craftswoman? What's the basis? Because we talked about it earlier.
What?
Someone of their craft. What makes a great craftsperson or crafts? What's the first, what's the major ingredient in someone being a master of their craft?
Oh, I think we had said your passion.
Exactly,
you're passionate,
right?
About it.
No, but consistency.
Ah.
Because you could be passionate about something.
That's right.
And
be lazy.
No, it's not even lazy.
Yeah.
It's about this, especially this generation of just like instant gratification. You know, you want it right now, and that's fair. You know what I'm saying? Because when you put a lot of time into something,
that's not fair.
It is fair, because you put a lot of time into something, you're not getting what you want out of it.
But you're not,
the time frame that you've invested into it, you're gonna feel some type of way about that.
Work that you put in.
You put in time. You
because
put in
because
you put
the
in
way
ideas.
The way
areas, yeah.
The way certain people are moving, they thinking they just put in work because they just put something online and that's it. No, you got to do your footwork. You
got
to do your footwork. You got to do your business work,
yeah,
and everything else like that.
I'm talking about those people that are doing the steps you're saying.
Mm-hmm.
Those people that are doing everything you're saying have a right to feel bad when they don't get the return.
They fall
in the
short,
time frame.
Of course.
Yeah, when they fall short and they're not getting.
So,
you know what I mean?
Now, you just said that, right?
Yeah.
What time frame are you talking about from the beginning of you making your move to where you feel that you're going to be satisfied with what you make? What time frame?
For example, right? You know, like a lot of artists will come out and they have all this massive success. And what do they say? Oh, you know, I wrote this song 12 years ago.
Absolutely.
You know, I wrote this song 10 years ago. You know, I've been doing this for 35 years and all of that
he
stuff.
Was sleeping in his car for
yeah,
how long
I've been homeless. I've been
right?
Da, 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 da.
2 years.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Like, those are a long, that's a long time to wait for people to acknowledge you.
No. See,
that's
look,
a marathon,
but
not
that's,
a sprint.
That's what you call, right, paying dues. See, when you go into it, when you going into a business or something that you're doing and you're looking for money out of it, it's you're gonna be frustrated all the time because that's what you're looking for.
And what?
Instead of going into it for the love that you're doing it, and then the money is gonna be a bonus when it comes back
and
to you.
That's why I talked about hustling
gotta,
for money.
Right,
don't
so,
treat it like a hustle for
right,
money.
Right. So you got to understand. An average business for it to grow is going to take between anywhere 2 years to 5 years from the start. So
but,
that's something you got to understand.
And I agree with what you're saying. I understand exactly your thought process on that. But the frustration comes in from the fact that even if we're talking on a business level, you've spent money.
Mm-hmm.
You spent money that probably was something you really needed because you believed in yourself and you expected that people believed in your product as well to see a return.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So even on a financial level, you're like, all right, let me put this 500 into this.
I got no sort of apparel coming out.
Let me
who knows?
Yo, listen.
Yeah.
I know we got like 4 minutes left,
yes,
right?
Sir.
I got my apologies about the downloading of your music and
yeah,
everything.
No,
so,
not a problem.
But I do want to leave out on your song again so everybody know what time it is. So we definitely going to leave out
lovely.
On that song, right?
Yeah.
And all y'all, man, thank y'all for tuning in. This is TERESA TAYLOR.
Thank you, guys.
TERESA TAYLOR, SOS.
Be my Superman and save me. Looking for my hero. And I have no time for another zero. Give me sweet things and make me feel good. Can you love me?
Love me.
Wanna meet your mama. Tell me nice things and bring me flowers. Stay up on the phone and talk for hours. Then you put it on me.
On me.
SOS with the S up on your chest. Just be my Superman and save me, yeah. SOS with the S up on your chest. Just be my Superman and save me, yeah. Be my Superman and save
to be strong for somebody like me. Anything I need you, right there by my side and I could feel you. Be my lifeline, I wanna need you. Come and save me. SOS with the S up on your chest. Just be my Superman and save me, yeah. SOS with the S up on your chest. Just be my Superman and save me, yeah.